everybody. Wish you all good evening. Carlton Hill, as you have seen here, we are going to have the first part of a four-part series workshop, okay, on the eight jewels of Tai Chi, Chi Gong. Okay, how many of you have heard of Tai Chi? Okay, some haven't done. To explain to you in a nutshell, Tai Chi first. Tai Chi is or was supposed to be a martial art which comes from China. Okay, nowadays the martial art aspect of Tai Chi is known to a very few, but the healing aspect of Tai Chi, or the healing Tai Chi teachers teach practitioners practice Tai Chi for the healing benefit of Tai Chi. Okay? Qi Gong. Qi, the Chinese language, means energy. Gong is the practice of energy work. Without Qi Gong, without the practice of energy work, Tai Chi is a simple dance. To be more profoundly involved in the benefit of getting a healing through the Tai Chi exercise, you have to know energy work or you have to know Qi Gong. So again, to bring it to you in a nutshell, Qi Gong, or the energy that we talk about Tai Chi, into three different sections: energy of the cosmic or the spiritual energy, energy of the atmosphere, yeah, above the earth, there is energy of the natural elements, energy of plants, trees, animals, flowers, you name it, and the energy that is below the earth. These are the three aspects of Qi Gong, the three energies which are in Tai Chi. How is Tai Chi? Tai Chi looks, when you see a Tai Chi practitioner, like a very, I won't say ballet, but a very slow dance-like form. Okay, the speed which it is going to be done is the same speed that you are also going to practice it. It's not that today when I show you a demo of what is Tai Chi, it's not that you are going to do it on purpose, you are going to do it slowly so that you see the movements. No. The slower, the better. Okay? Now, Tai Chi is soul, mind and body. Most of us are involved whenever we do any kind of exercise with the mind and the body. The body goes into a particular action. We put our bodies into a posture. It goes like yoga asanas, bodybuilding, aerobics, and these kinds of things. Okay? If you put the mind, okay? The mind is intention to get to the essence of the action that you are doing. Okay? I may stand with my feet together with my eyes closed. If I don't put my mind, I sway. The moment I put my mind to the exercise, I don't sway. Okay? Then, very, very, very few. 1%, 0.5% in 100% grade, put the soul into the mind and the body. Putting the soul. Okay, very controversial subject. All my lectures, people always tell me, deal with very controversial subjects, talking about soul. I don't think so, putting a soul into body and mind is rather controversial, unless you want to make it a controversy. The question that I ask in my lectures, what does the soul mean to you? And then we get different kinds of answers. Soul is this, soul is this, soul is that, soul is that. Okay? Make it very simple. Why don't we call the soul a bright light within us and around us? Doesn't it sound nice? Instead of telling you the soul is this color, this is what it does, that is what it does. So for us in Tai Chi, putting the soul is that bright spiritual light which is within us and which gives us the energy or creates a connection between us, human beings, mind, body, and the cosmic. Okay? So that is your soul. And I won't talk about others, but let me tell you.
As I grew up, from childhood to my youth, to going into college, to getting degrees, to getting into living life, this dim light started flickering.
It's showing on your face.
This is a good one. The dim light started flickering. After that, when I realized that this dim light is flickering and I have to brighten it up, okay, then I have to get all the currents, all the electric currents, all the powers. And that came to me by learning Tai Chi and Qigong. No more does this light flicker, no more is this light dim, the light is bright. So this could be a very good explanation to what the soul is. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Very good. Beautiful people with beautiful answers. Okay? So that's how the soul, mind and body. Now what is the soul? Energy. What is that mind power or the intent? Energy. What does this body action when I talk to you create? Energy. So energy is everywhere. Everything is energy. Okay? Very simply to put it. That's how Tai Chi is a combination of soul, mind and body. Okay? The food for the soul is meditation. Okay? The food for the mind, intention. Unwavering intention. Okay? The food for your body, positive actions. Okay? Positive action is very simply. I'm not pointing a finger at you people, so you can sit as relaxed as you want. But bodily energy or the body action is when you sit respecting your body, your spine. You can sit down, nobody. That's why I said I'm not pointing a finger at you guys. Okay? So this is it. Because let me tell you this, when I was in China, in Shanghai, and when I was learning Tai Chi, I asked my teacher, you see there is an antidote to everything. Why do people become old? How do people become old? How does ailments creep in? And you know, I was standing like this and talking to him. And he told me, keep doing this, keep standing in this posture as you are standing, with your body weight on one side. Okay? And very surely, after some years, you will know when your waist pains, your lumbar goes out of commission, your knees go out of commission. What he was pointing out was posture. Right action, right posture of the body also can keep you healthy. For our comfort, many of us, like you are sitting, even I used to do the same thing. I still do the same thing sometimes when I forget I'm a Tai Chi. So even I slouch. But of course, this slouching gives us comfort because the body, the mind and the soul are not working in harmony with each other. Okay? So, Tai Chi brings the body, the mind and the soul in working in harmony with each other. When the body and mind and the soul are in harmony with each other, then you are living a harmonious energy life, which is health, happiness and enlightenment. Okay? I think so I have explained much more about Tai Chi. Right? So, now Tai Chi, there are different styles of Tai Chi. If you have heard of Tai Chi, if you go to read of Tai Chi, you have the net to serve plenty of things. You see different styles, Wu style, Sun style, Chen style tradition, Chen style modern, Yang style, down to style, many, many styles. Each Tai Chi movement are made into combination of sets. So you start with doing 8 sets of exercises, right up to 108 to 160 sets of exercises. Okay? And then you need space. Right? I think so, only maybe 6 or 7 of you could do an 8 movement Tai Chi form in this form. But can you imagine somebody doing, or a big crowd of people doing 108 moves or maybe 60 moves? We need a bigger space. So all the benefit of this Tai Chi form for people to practice in a smaller area and get the same amount of benefit, same amount of body, mind and soul, soul, mind and body benefit, had to be condensed. Had to be condensed to make it available to people to practice anywhere, anytime, whether the person is able body to stand on his 2 feet or whether the person is not able body to stand on his 2 feet and do it even sitting down. Now it is said even up to date, and even in my times in the 70s when I was in Shanghai, 70s, 80s, I would see, especially in the military area, in the services, the Army, Navy and Air Force of China, even up to date, practices Tai Chi and Qigong. Okay, and we, as we all know, the Red Army is supposed to be the largest in the world. So, maybe, I don't know what we call it, thousands of people maybe in one cantonment somewhere, practicing 108 moves, you need a huge place, boss. And I'm sure forms take from 5 minutes right up to 1 hour to do. So I don't think so that the Chinese army or the government would advise 1 hour of training to so many people. So they had to condense this, make it smaller, make it easier, but not losing on the benefits. In the years gone by, around 200 to 300 years after Tai Chi was founded, Hindi Red Army was Marshal Yo He Fa, who was in those days one of the best Tai Chi and Qigong practitioners, who with all his experience of Tai Chi, movement, breathing exercises, that is Qigong, formed 8 moves from 108 to 160 moves. He taught us the best 8 moves. And he called it 8 jewels of Tai Chi Qigong. It is also known as 8 brocades. It is also known as silk weaving exercises. Okay? It is also known in the Chinese language as Ba Duan Qin. Sometimes it is spelled Ba Ba. Sometimes it is known as Pa Duan Qin. Okay? Again, because of the dialect of Canton and Mandarin and all that. And there are different versions of 8 jewels. What I will be showing you in this 4-part series is the most simplest and the most powerful moves which can be performed.